Joining us now on Encounter is Father Eddie Siebert, who is the founder and president of Loyola Productions. Thank you so much for being with us on Encounter.
Thanks for having me, Kevin. It's great.
Maybe if you could start off telling us a little bit about Loyola Productions and how it all started.
Okay, I'll give you the short version. I'm a Jesuit priest. I've always wanted to work in this business. I'm originally from Cleveland, Ohio, and I wanted to go to film school after I was ordained back in 97. I went to film school, and then after that, did some work in town in Los Angeles, got some experience, and then we started Loyola Productions. And the bottom line is the Jesuits really didn't have a presence in working in the media. So we said, well, let's do it. And so that was a while ago, and this is what we've been doing ever since, working and trying to tell the good news.
Is this something that has always been with you? Have you always been interested in media and film growing up?
Yeah, and it's grown. I mean, I've always had a passion to tell stories. And I mean, that's what Jesus did. That's how you inspire people. That's how you change the course of history. Tell stories and people respond. So we thought, you know, why not use this modern technology, film, television, internet at the time, and make a difference? So that's basically what we did. We tapped into our resources and said, let's go to work and do it.
Now, you're a full-service production company in Los Angeles. What's it like working in L.A. amongst all the Hollywood types?
Well, I mean, first of all, I work with an amazing, talented group of people who are all committed, who could be in other studios and working in other endeavors. But they're committed to what we're all about, you know, which is, you know, helping people find God in all things, which is tricky in a business when really it's a business and you're trying to make a lot of money, because that's what most of the executives want to do. And they're just getting programming out there. So not all, but basically they want to just get out there. So there's challenges to work with certain folks because they're only interested in the bottom line and they're only interested in telling a certain type of story. We want to raise the bar a little bit and get people thinking outside themselves, get people realizing that God is active in their world. Now, we don't want to be preachy or dogmatic. We're not interested in that. We're just interested in telling really positive stories, stories that can inspire others. So, but I can give you examples if you want.
Sure.
Well, I not too long ago I was talking to an agent and she said, you know, these are all great, Father, but you're being too inspiring. And I thought, well, why is that bad? I think people want to be inspired. On the other hand, there's a lot of good programming in Los Angeles and out there in the world, but you got to look for it. Yeah. And so our goal is to just be in there and be in the mix. I mean, let people pick and choose. I think they'll go for the story if it's done well.
How do you decide on a project, and how does that process work? Is this a collaboration type thing?
Or I mean, do you want me to be honest?
Sure. We're all about honesty on account.
Okay, good. No, we have to keep the lights on. So we have to do some programming that may not be as most exciting, but it's got a good message. So we do a lot of industrials and help out other nonprofits and things like that. And hopefully we can get some money and keep the lights on. But all in all, we're always trying to develop programs. We come together, we have brainstorming sessions, we talk to other executives, we look at the trends of what's happening out there, and we read and talk and come up with ideas and bat it out there.
So. And do you find too, I noticed recently in Hollywood, there are, it seems like a little more positive message films that are coming out. And what's that been like? Is that helpful for you, I would assume, as Hollywood starts to take a look at that?
You're spot on. And there is a trend right now where all of a sudden religious programming or faith-filled programming, faith-based programming is really popular. And you can see the upsurge in this. I was at a summit sponsored by Variety Magazine not too long ago, and they basically had all these people talking about this trend. And I think it's this response to people's desire for something a little better. To give themselves a little bit more coming from the heart instead of just this sort of washing yourself of this stupidity. Yeah. I mean, it's ridiculous. Anyways, there's some programming that's really smart, but I've got to tell you, when I take these meetings, it's ridiculous what they want. They want to get into this stupid sensationalism, and people are smarter than that. So anyways, getting back to there is a surge in faith-based programming. I don't know how long it's going to last, but I think execs are realizing, hey, there's money to be made here. So they're going to do that. Does it help us? I think it does. But we have to get our act together because now there's a niche and we got to start putting forward some of our material.
Yeah. And what are some of the things that you're working on now? What are some of the projects?
Well, one of the things that we did, we started our own online network called the IN Network. It's the Ignatian Network, because we see things through the Ignatian lens, which is the Jesuit lens. Some of the programming that we're doing is, I think, basic stuff, like a movie review show with this sister who really knows her stuff. It's short, as she tackles everything. A cooking show, or I should say it's a short Preprans show, which is Preprans means happy hour, Jesuit style, and it's about bringing people together. We're doing larger documentaries, more serious, about the Jesuits who were killed in El Salvador 25 years ago. We have some short morality tales that we're developing, narrative style. We hope to get off the ground. Another show we're developing with a Jesuit is called the Jesuit Rec Room, talking about topics, things that are happening in the world that young people might be interested, relationship, vocation, spirituality, you know, marriage, all that stuff.
That's great. Sounds like a lot of great projects.
We're busy.
And yeah. You're loving your work. You can see it through. Yeah.
Like I said, I work with amazing people, and I couldn't do it without them.
So, yeah. Well, we thank you so much, Father, for being with us. If people want to find out more about Loyola Productions, where would they go?
Go to theinnetwork.org.
Okay. That's great. The best place. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Kevin. It's great.